Hello friends, welcome to IBPS guide. Myself Ravi Prakash sir. Today is day 44. We are going to take boat and stream problems. Basics 5 questions we are going to take. So, and our mission is SBI PO 2019. So before starting the session, I would recommend you to go through day 1 and day 2 video, because in this video we have talked about the tips of multiplication, finding square root and all other tricks that we are using in our problem. And also go through day 40 and day 41 video, okay? And so let us begin the session. Before going to the problems, I would like to go through the concept of boat and stream. What does it mean? Suppose the most important concept in boat and stream, there will be two terms, that is upstream and another is downstream. So let us take first example, that is upstream. Suppose there is a river, or you can consider it to be ocean also, and there is a ship. This is the ship, Pirates of Caribbean. Okay, so it is going in this direction, and suppose the water is flowing in this direction. So what will be the value of the relative speed? That would be, suppose boat is going with speed of B and water is going with speed of W, so relative speed will be P minus W, okay? This is the relative speed, and you can visualize it that way also. If this is flowing in this direction, this is water is pushing it against, it is not allowing it to move forward. So boat minus water speed, so upstream it should come to your mind, P minus W. Similarly downstream, let me draw this boat again. So this is the boat, okay? So it is going this way, boat speed is this way, and suppose water is also going in this direction. So what will be the relative speed? B plus W, that is it will add up, because it is water is helping the boat to move forward. So relative speed, this is called as downstream. These two are the most important concept in this boat and stream problem. So let us go to first problem. A boat can row 16 km along the current, that is along the current, so downstream relative speed would be B plus W will be how much? 16. And 14 km against the current, that is upstream case, it is the case of upstream, so B minus W will be how much? 14. Now find the speed of current and speed of boat. Now it is very simple, just add these two equations, this and this will get cancelled. 2B will be how much? 30. B will be how much? 15. So find the speed of the current and boat. So boat speed is this much, current speed will be how much? 16 minus 15 is 1. So the value would be 1E. Let us go to question number 2. A boat running downstream covers a distance of 40 km in 4 hours. Downstream. So boat plus water, downstream distance by time. 40 by 4, that is 10. And again covering the same distance in upstream. So upstream B minus W, distance is same, the time is 8, that is 5. So what is the speed of boat? Boat will be how much? Sum of these two, that is 2B, that is 15. B will be how much? 7.5. B is how much? 7.5, that is 2C. Let us go through question number 3. A boat can travel 3.5 km upstream in 14 minutes. If the ratio of the speed of the boat in still water to the speed of the stream is this much, how much time will the boat take to cover 36 km downstream? So if you see, the answer is in minute. So please, like rest of the student, don't convert this minute into seconds or hours, it will not be of any use. So let us solve this problem. Upstream, let us consider boat minus water, upstream is how much? 3.5 into 14, so this will be 35. Let us take, remove the point, 140, this will be 5 times, this will be 2 times 1 by 4, okay? Now what it is saying, if the ratio of the speed of the boat to water, speed of the water is, boat is this much and the speed of the stream is this much, that is water is this much, so how much time will it take to cover this much distance? So we know the difference between these two values is this much, so let us find the value of 1 unit. 7 minus 2 is 5, 5 unit is value equivalent to 1 by 4, 1 is equivalent to 1 by 20. So B will be how much? 7 by 20, so don't convert, don't, this will be also 2 by 20. Let us simplify, let us keep it as it is, because it will help in our problem. If you convert it, it will be a problem. Simply it will make the problem lengthier. What it is saying, how much time will it take to cover this much distance downstream? Okay, so distance, speed is distance by time. So time is distance by speed. Distance, speed is how much? 7 minus 2 is 5. 20 goes up, this will be, so it is downstream, it will be not difference but sum, you know, 9 times, so this was 20, it will go for 4 times, so value will be 80 minutes. So the most important thing in the problem was to understand is not to waste your time in converting this minute into second. So it would be a benefit for you if you see the options, what, in what unit they have given you the answer in. Okay, so this question number 4 is a homework for you. So please try to solve the problem on your own and give the solution in the comment. I go through comment and we read the comment and see how many of you are giving the answers. Okay, and also you saw that you have understood the concept, your concept of this particular topic is clear. So let us go to question number 5. So this is the last question in our session. What it is saying is, speed of a main in still water is 5 km and the speed of the and running and the river is running at this much, the total time to go to a place is 10 km. What is the distance traveled? So you must remember this, this is x kilometer while going, and while this is x, total distance is x suppose. So while going it covers x, while coming it also covers x. So total distance, how much it is covering? 2x. So what time does it take in the total? 10 hours. So 10 is equivalent to, first how much it is going? X. It is going in a downstream or upstream. Going to a place is 8, coming to from there is difference of these two, that is 2. Okay, let us take the bracket out, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 2. Okay, now so we have got the value to be 10x is equal, 10 is equal to x into this. Let us simplify it. X LCM will be 8, 1 times 4 times, so 10, x is equivalent to 5 8, so this will be 2, x will be 16. Now they have asked you not the distance, not in that length of the distance between two places, this is important, the distance traveled. So while going x, while coming x, 2x, that is 32. So value would be 5d. So if you found the video knowledgeable, give it a like and please comment how you feel about the videos, and don't forget to give the answer of the solution which I've asked you. Okay, and do share with your friends on all the social media websites like Facebook, and also share with your friends on WhatsApp group, and do subscribe to the IBPS guide channel. So bye bye, see you in the next session.